Let's look at normal quantile-quantile plots, which can help answer the question, is a set of observations approximately normally distributed? If a set of observations is approximately normally distributed, a normal quantile-quantile plot of the observations will result in an approximately straight line. We sometimes call a quantile-quantile plot a QQ plot for short. Here's an example of a normal quantile-quantile plot for a sample of size 9 from a normally distributed population. These points fall in a pretty straight line. We sometimes draw a line in for a little perspective. More on that line a little bit later. Assessing normality is important, as many statistical inference procedures assume we are sampling from a normally distributed population. And so we are going to want to investigate that assumption to see if it's reasonable. Now let's work through some of the details in how a normal quantile-quantile plot is constructed. Does the following sample come from a normally distributed population? First, we're going to order the data from smallest to largest, and then we're going to plot these values against the appropriate quantiles from the standard normal distribution. Let's look at that in a little more detail. Here we have the standard normal probability density function truncated at minus 3 and 3. And down here, we have our 9 sample values. And what we're going to do is we're going to place 9 values down here for a standard normal random variable such that the distribution is split up into n plus 1 or 10 equal areas. So we're going to split this distribution up into 10 equal areas because we're placing 9 values down here, and so the distribution is going to be split up into 10 areas. And that looks like this. It might be a little hard to tell, but this value says 0.1. All of these areas are 0.1 because there were 10 areas and the area under the entire curve is 1, of course. And now we're going to find the values of a standard normal random variable that make that happen. So we could go to computer software or possibly a standard normal table. We would find this first value, rounded to 2 decimal places, is minus 1.28. Now let's do that for a few more of them. I'd put all 9 of those values in, but that would look a little messy here, so I just put in 5 of them. Now, if we were sampling 9 values from a standard normal distribution, a little loosely speaking, we would expect the smallest value to be around minus 1.28. And this one's not written there, but it's minus 0.84 to 2 decimal places. We would expect the second smallest value to be around minus 0.84, and the third smallest value to be about minus 0.52, and so on and so forth, up to the largest value around 1.28. So what we're going to do is we're going to plot the smallest value in our sample of size 9 against what we would expect to get as the smallest value in a sample of size 9 from the standard normal distribution, and the second smallest value against what we would expect to get as the second smallest value in a sample of the same size from the standard normal distribution, all the way up to plotting our largest value in the sample against what we would expect to get for our largest value from a standard normal distribution of the same sample size. And if our data is approximately normally distributed, that should result in an approximately straight line. Now we could have picked a different normal distribution. We didn't have to pick the standard normal distribution. Some things would change in terms of the scaling, but overall the general idea would be the same if we were to use any normal distribution, but we typically simply use the standard normal distribution. And if we were to plot that out, here's what we'd get. I'm labeling the y-axis here as the sample quantiles, and those are simply our observed values in the sample. And on the x-axis, I've got the theoretical quantiles. And loosely speaking, those are the values we'd expect to get in a sample of this size from the standard normal distribution. And the resulting plot is a pretty darn straight line. So this would say that that sample data is approximately normally distributed. And just in case it's not clear what these points represent, this value here is the smallest value observed in our sample of 3.89, and it was plotted against the corresponding value from the standard normal curve of minus 1.28, and similarly for the rest of them. What did we just do here? We plotted the ith ordered value, sometimes called the ith order statistic, against the I over n plus 1th quantile of the standard normal distribution. So for example, when I was 1, we took the smallest value in our sample, and we plotted that against 1 over, we had a sample of size 9, so 9 plus 1, or 0.1, and the 0.1th quantile of the standard normal distribution. Or in other words, if we have 0.1 to the left, this value here that yields 0.1 to the left is the 0.1th quantile of the standard normal curve, also called the 10th percentile, if we wanted to call it that. And we use that method for all of our ordered data values. Instead of using I over n plus 1, there's a variety of other possibilities, such as I minus a half over n, or more generally, I minus a over n plus 1 minus 2a, where a is some number between 0 and a half. This, if we think about this is the same as the general method with a of a half, and what we had up here is the same as the general formulation with a of 0. And different values of a have been proposed as well. But let's not get too bogged down in that. What we are simply trying to do is come up with a method that approximates what we would expect to get if we were sampling from the standard normal distribution. Now let's look at a few things we might see in practice. Usually in practice, of course, we use statistical software to actually do the plotting. And here I'm going to use the statistical software R. R's method differs slightly from what I described earlier, but overall the idea is the same. In this first plot, I'm sampling 50 observations from a normally distributed population, and we get a normal quantile-quantile plot here that results in a pretty darn straight line. This line is drawn in for a little perspective, and R draws in a line that joins the first and third quartiles. But there are other lines we could draw in, but that's R's method. So overall, our points form a pretty darn straight line, which shouldn't be too surprising because we are indeed sampling from a normally distributed population. But let's see a couple of instances where we're not sampling from a normally distributed population. Here I'm drawing a random sample of 50 observations from a uniform distribution. And if I was to superimpose a normal curve over this, say, we'd see that the uniform distribution is truncated tails, so we're not going to get extreme values in this distribution. How that manifests itself in the normal quantile-quantile plot is that these values, corresponding to the large values in our sample, are not as far out in the right tail as would be expected if we were sampling from a normally distributed population. And the smallest values in our sample are not as far out in the left tail as would be expected if we were sampling from a normally distributed population. So we see this curvature here. One thing to keep in mind is that there are different plotting methods, and sometimes people switch the axes here and have the theoretical quantiles on the y-axis and the sample quantiles on the x-axis. In some ways, it doesn't really matter. We're still going to see the curvature, but we just have to be careful in our interpretation of what that means. Here I'm drawing 50 observations from a distribution that is strongly right-skewed. And what we see in our normal quantile-quantile plot is that the largest values in our sample are much larger than would be expected if we were sampling from a normally distributed population, because we've got this heavy right tail here. But in the left tail, the dots creep above the line here, indicating that the smallest values in our sample are not as extreme as would be expected under normality. And we can see that up here in our PDF, as it ends pretty quickly here at zero. Here I'm drawing 50 observations from a heavy-tailed distribution, a distribution that has greater area in the tails than the standard normal distribution, so we're going to expect to get more extreme values. And we see that in our normal quantile-quantile plot. These values in the right tail of our distribution, the largest values, are even larger than would be expected under normality. And these values in the left tail of the distribution, our smallest sample values, are even more extreme than would be expected under normality as well. Properly interpreting normal quantile-quantile plots can be a little tricky without some experience. But fortunately, we can get some experience pretty quickly using simulation. What I've plotted out here is the normal quantile-quantile plot for a sample of size 50 from the standard normal distribution. And this results in a pretty darn straight line. But sometimes, of course, natural variability will lead to us seeing some curvature or a major outlier or something along those lines. So I'm going to replicate this or carry this out 20 times and see what these different normal quantile-quantile plots look like when we are in fact sampling from a normally distributed population. When the sample size is a little bit smaller, the variability can be a bit more extreme. So let's see what it looks like for a sample of size 10. This is the normal quantile-quantile plot for a sample of size 10 from a normally distributed population. Let's do this 20 times and see what the variability is like. So that's our introduction to normal quantile-quantile plots, and we'll be using this method to investigate the normality assumption in a variety of different statistical inference procedures.